This is 7 National News, and in our top story, the Dubai Health Authority and the General Directorate for Residency and Foreigners Affairs have agreed to unify medical tourism procedures through a memorandum of understanding in order to promote Dubai as a destination for medical tourism. According to a local paper, the MOU was signed on Wednesday, which comes in line with the directives of His Highness Sheikh Hamdan bin Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, the Crown Prince of Dubai. The first phase of the initiative, which was announced in November last year, provided hospitals with information on how to apply for medical tourism visas. The second phase will involve specialised clinics, spas and wellness centres. Through the initiative, overseas patients who wish to have treatment here in Dubai will be able to take advantage of a 3-month medical tourist visa, extendable twice up to 9 consecutive months. The Abu Dhabi Executive Council is looking at building 5 multi-story car parks in busy areas of the city to help solve parking space shortages. According to a local daily, the car parks are to be built on top of existing parking spaces on the Cornish Road, Khalifa bin Zayed Street and the interjunction between Khaled bin Walid Street and Al Nasser Street, as well as the interjunction between Hamadan bin Mohammed Street and Al Najda Street. The car parks will also be temporary so that they can be moved to other areas if needs be. Meanwhile, the Executive Council's committee also decided on the establishment of an abattoir to New Shahama, as well as 3 new kindergartens. Dubai is all geared up to host the Standard Chartered Marathon this Friday, which will start and finish on Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Boulevard in downtown Dubai. Marathon organisers are warning the public, however, of heavy congestion and also in the surrounding areas. They're advising the community to not park in the area and that there will be extensive road closures, which will lead from downtown to the World Trade Centre via Road 312, parallel to Sheikh Zayed Road. The track will then diverge to Al Diafa Street and back via Jumeirah Road. The roads will be closed from 5 a.m. until 1 p.m. However, the 2 walkways across Sheikh Zayed Road at the Business Bay Metro Station and the Dubai Mall Metro Station will be open on the morning of the race. This season's spring-summer 2013 fashion trends were showcased this week through a rather unconventional platform, as Dubai Metro's carriage was transformed into a catwalk. Dubai Fashion 2013 got off to an exciting start on Wednesday when the first in its series of unique shows, the Express Fashion, took a unique ride aboard a moving train. Boarding from the Burj Khalifa Dubai Mall station at around 1 p.m, the Metro took models and guests on a journey throughout the city, offering them a panoramic view of the city's awe-inspiring architecture. In collaboration with the Road and Transport Authority and Bloomingdale's, this is just one of the many events taking place as part of the month-long Dubai Shopping Festival. A combination of black and white is the look for this season, according to fashion experts, while lace and ice cream colours are recommended as staple items for your collection.
It gave us a wonderful opportunity to preview the Spring-Summer 13 collections. We've got an official launch in store on the 7th of February with a Round the World program. But it gave us an opportunity for the guests that were on the Metro to be able to see some of these wonderful looks, black and white, graphic prints, lace, ice cream colours, and of course the wonderful strong cobalt blues, orange and yellow in the evening wear at the end of the collection. So it was really about showing Dubai what those key looks and key trends are for the season.
As you know, it's a new event, never been happened, and it's a very innovative idea. So we are proud to be part of it. And why we are participating? Because we are supporting any new idea, innovative idea that will support as well to promote for the Metro, for Dubai, and for UAE.
And finally, looking to other news, the Crystal Arc Group, which boasts clients such as UAE regional and UK royalty, as well as the likes of Bill Clinton, recently introduced its Nakawa brand and is going on a global tour next month to boost its client reach for the first time. The Nakawa brand, which means pure in Arabic, sees a glass paste process for art glass and crystal sculptures, originally invented by the Egyptians, where every piece passes through 18 stages before reaching the stores. Crystal Arc boasts being a leading supplier of crystal trophies to a number of award-winning institutions, including the Sheikh Khalifa Excellence Award, the Sheikh Khalifa Industrial Award, the Sheikh Mohammed Award for Young Business Leaders, and the Endurance World Cup, among many others.
Corporate business has been our main, our source of business at the moment. And a lot of government institutions, multinationals, are basically buyers of the corporate line of business. In addition to that, with the new line of products at Nakawa, we are looking at a retail presence. And we would be looking at distributors in and around the region, for which, even globally, so for which we are participating in our first international show at Frankfurt in Germany, which will be in February. In March, we go to Moscow. In June, in Japan. And we have four shows lined up for the United States in the coming year of 2013.